Sijur is about the 6 days of the LA riots. It takes place in 1992. And it mainly follows the stories of Latino gang members, but it also follows firefighters, nurses, graffiti artists. And what it tries to do is encapsulate what happens, or what happened, excuse me, in Los Angeles during the 6 days of the LA riots, which were, to this day, the worst civic event in the history of the United States. You know, I think the riots struck me as novel material out of necessity. I spent 2.5 years researching the book. I spent a tremendous amount of time with former Latino gang members, and I very much wanted to write a female gang member character. And I asked these former gang members if that was all right, and they said no. You know, a woman wouldn't be involved. That's not how it works. But I went home, and I was so captivated by this idea, this voice, and I thought, you know, I absolutely have to write this character, but what I needed was an opportunity that would give her the freedom to act as she needed to act. And that's when I thought of the LA riots. And it was this moment of relief, but also terror, because I knew that it would take a tremendous amount of research to do it justice and really write it properly. The female character, her name is Payasa. That's her gang name. It means clown girl, and she is in many ways a peripheral part of the gang. Her little brother is in it. The boss of the gang is living in their house because he doesn't have a place to stay. And when her older brother, her oldest brother, is murdered, she has to make a decision. You know, she has to decide, do I go out for vengeance? Or do I let my little brother do it? But everyone knows her little brother is crazy, and he doesn't care who gets hurt along the way, whereas she is very precise and very targeted, and she wants to make sure that she visits the same pain on whoever did it, you know, that she is feeling as a result of her brother's death. As far as my literary inspirations for the book are concerned, you know, I very much look to classic Los Angeles fiction, you know, everyone from John Fante to James M. Cain, Raymond Chandler. But there's also a really fabulous book by a former LA Times journalist called The Killing Season by a man named Miles Corwin. And in it, he spends a good amount of time with a homicide squad in South Central Los Angeles. And it is just heartbreaking and incredibly detailed and just a really, really wonderful story about the types of crimes and people who live in this area. And I felt in many ways, I learned so much from his book, and I felt like I had a sense of tone, and I had a sense of what details were vital. So I went out and then I sought those in my own research. If I had to save one book in a fire, it would be Ask the Dust by John Fante. You know, it almost wasn't published. The publisher who wanted to put it out was very much invested in making Fante the next Faulkner. But then they got sued by Adolf Hitler. And because they had put out an unauthorized translation of Mein Kampf. And he sued them successfully and almost completely destroyed the publishing house. A little bit after that, they did put out Ask the Dust, but it sunk without a trace, and it wasn't until Charles Bukowski discovered it in the reading room of the LA Public Library that it actually saw the light of day again and was republished. It's such a phenomenal book about being an outsider in Los Angeles, which is absolutely something I relate to. And I think in many ways, I just relate to Fante in general because I'm from Colorado and he's from Colorado. He moved to Los Angeles very young and started writing, and I've done the same thing. It's almost as if our paths are one, even though they are many years apart. And just the poetry within the prose is just so magical and magnificent. It's just, it's not so much a book as a magic spell, I think, at least for me.